at Swindon, the anticipation of Wembley had hardly started when there was ominous speculation in the press that Glenn Hoddle's future lay with Chelsea. No one was saying anything, but everyone had read the stories in the papers.
Spearman, Bolden, Ridder,
Swindon have a fluid, attacking, adventurous style with their fullbacks playing virtually as wingers. On it goes to Maskell, he's onside. He has Mitchell in the box, otherwise he's full of Leicester defenders. So he goes outside the box to Moncaire. Good run by him, and now Maskell!
If we win, and hopefully we will win, because we all want them to win, and you know, it'd be a great day. It'd be a great day for, you know, I know we're only going to be there, but we'll walk out on the pitch before, and we'll lap it all up. But if they win, there'll be some moment in during the night, as Oggy said, where we'll be sitting down having a drink with our wives or whatever, girlfriends, and we'll think to ourselves, you know, really, we weren't anything to do with
that's how we felt before, the last time.
That's how we felt before, yeah.
And it goes high towards Taylor. Walsh got there ahead of him, though. Moncaire plays it back in again, and no offside! And Taylor has scored! And that surely means it's the Premier League for Swindon Town now! The big defender gets his 13th goal of the season. He who hesitates pays the price. Taylor threw his head in where it hurts, and he is rewarded with the most crucial goal of Swindon's season. Philpott hugging the left touchline, and Oldfield gets it back to him. That's a good ball. Philpott's cross is an excellent one. Walsh is there, and Joachim buries the rebound. Leicester have a moment of hope. Well, I personally enjoyed the first half. The second half is proving even better, and it's only 12 minutes old.
The first half lacked the frenzy that some enjoy in the goalmouth, but for purists it was all poise and style, and no two halves are ever the same, and this half's exploded now.
And he curls it beautifully over to the far post. Philpott turning it back in again. Walsh goes up with the keeper, and it's in! It's 3-2! incredible! Well, what a wonderful game of football this is. Both the goals scored, the second, of course. Whitlow drives forward now. He's got Joachim and looks for Thompson. And Thompson has equalised! It's unbelievable stuff now! You can't pause for breath.
Steve Thompson can't finish once again, taking a leap out the hobble book.
The last card John could play is to put Steve White on. Steve's the sort of player who can G things up a bit. 5 minutes later, he'd won them a penalty. Two days later, on the day of their triumphant victory parade through the town, the news is dominated by the speculation.